You know, it's really easy to fall into negative thinking patterns. In fact, for most of us, we've been brought up and socialized in such a way that thinking negatively and thinking about the worst case scenario is almost like a natural tendency. It's almost normal to actually be thinking negative thoughts. But what you have to realize is the difference between the rich and the poor is not in the bank account. At first, it's in the mind. We all have 24 hours. We all have a certain amount of time on this planet, and we might have one life or 1,000, whatever you believe in. But the fact is that with where you're at right now, if you want to leap, if you want to take the next step, if you want to step up your level of performance, you're going to have to step up your level of thinking, because that's where it really all begins. That's really what it all comes down to. At the end of the day, your life is a direct representation, the sum of all your thoughts collected into one. Okay, your character, your persona, everything that you walk around, that you identify with as being this guy or girl, this person, this, you know, whether you're a CEO or whether you're an employee, whether you're a janitor or, you know, you're a motivational speaker, and I've made that transformation myself. It did not go from this place to this place through the circumstances changing or through somebody handing me something. It came through changing my thinking. And so if you're going around thinking about, well, how I'm never gonna make it, it's never gonna work, then I guarantee you it will never work, because that's the shift. That's where you get to pick. That's where you have a choice. You see that little bit of willpower, because most of the time we're running on autopilot. We're going throughout our day and we barely even remember what happened. Do you remember what you ate for the last week, the last 7 days? Can you recall all your meals? Most of the time, we won't be able to do that. Do you remember everyone that you talked to, all the conversations that you had, what they were about? Do you remember even that you drove somewhere yesterday? Because most of the time, we just, our subconscious mind drives us, right? It drives for us. We come to the destination and we say, oh, who drove all that way? I don't know if you ever had that experience. I sure have. So if you notice that a lot of the time you really aren't being 100% present, you realize that the presence that you do get, the time where you are conscious, that's the time that is most important, because you get to feed your mind. And hopefully right now, as you're watching this video, you are aware. And I want you to make a decision and a choice, because most people, by default, make a choice to think about the things that they don't want. And what you need to understand, what's so crucial, so important, and just one thing that I really want you to never forget, is that whether you focus on what you don't want or what you want, you are going to get it. Your subconscious mind, it just doesn't understand the difference between I don't want and I want. Whatever you put in, it'll run that program. And whether it says I don't want or want, that's what it'll produce, that result. And just remember that. So if you're going around thinking about, oh, please don't let this happen to me, don't let this happen to me. Ever had that experience? It just happened to you. And you're like, oh man, you know, I was thinking, I hope that doesn't happen to me. And then it happens. Or maybe you really wanted something. Here's the key though. You really want something, you really wish for it. That's also very difficult for the subconscious mind to wrap around, because it's so intangible, it's so fluffy. It's like, I wish, I hope, I pray. When you change that to something along the lines of, I am becoming, I am in the process of, I am achieving, all of a sudden, the results become that much more real. They become actually tangible. I noticed that I started to attract a lot of wealth and abundance in my life when I started to believe that I was in the process of creating that abundance, right? So it really all depends on whether or not you'll make the choice and the decision, the commitment to go from a level of wish, hope, and pray, or I don't want, which is the worst place to be. I don't want is definitely not something you want to engage with. But then there's I want, I wish, I hope, or I pray. And then the higher levels are I will, I am becoming, I will achieve, I'm in the process. All of a sudden, your subconscious mind goes, wait a minute, whoa, are we actually doing this? Like, wow, let's get engaged, let's get passionate. Your energy starts to flow through you, you feel good, your brain gets engaged with the activities that you're in instead of just running your mind wild and crazy on you. All of a sudden, you have some concentration, right? That's what happens when you put yourself in the process. And so I want your thoughts to encourage you and back you up on whatever it is that you're trying to achieve, whatever it is, whether you're studying in school or you're running for president, it doesn't matter. You need your thoughts backing you up and pushing you one level up at a time, just working your way up there constantly. And the only way that that's gonna happen is when you make that switch from want and wish and pray, or from I do not want this, to I am becoming. I am becoming. Remember that. I am becoming this person. I am achieving this goal. I am in the process. I am this person. Now that's the highest level. If you can genuinely switch your mind into a level of belief that you are somebody, that you have something that you don't yet have, or that you aren't yet, that's the most powerful and quickest switch. If you want that quick pill, that quick fix, that's the closest you'll ever get. The closest thing you'll ever get to changing overnight is to firmly and 100% believe that you are that person. You see, the reason I was able to build a business that I loved so quickly, the reason I was able to help so many people is because I didn't go to, oh, I wish, I hope, I pray. I didn't even go to I am becoming. I went to I am this person. I am this person. I am this person. And you might say that's delusional, right? A lot of people say that's delusional. That's crazy. In fact, I was told I'm crazy. And you might be told you're crazy too. And you know what? That means you're on the right track. All that means is you're doing something that other people aren't comfortable with. It's too far outside their reach. They can't grasp it. They can't believe it for themselves. They don't believe that they're able to do it. So they're gonna criticize you. They're gonna make you feel bad. But if you want to jump, if you want to leap, if you want to elevate yourself by a mile, then go straight for I am. I am this person. I am this person right now. And you have to convince yourself first before anybody else is convinced, right? The only way to sell a great product or to sell a lot of a product is to first sell yourself on that product. It's to first really firmly and deeply believe that it's worth something, that it can make a difference, that it can have an impact. And I need you to believe that not about a product, right? But about yourself, about you. That you can have a difference, that you can make an impact, that you have something. And those are the thoughts I want you to run through your mind every single day, repeatedly, like a playlist on repeats, constantly, constantly, constantly. And if you can do this for yourself, you will be so grateful. It will be beyond words how grateful you will feel towards yourself, right? And that's another tip, talking about gratitude. It's another tip that you can throw in there to get yourself on the right track in the morning. Instead of thinking about, oh God, how horrible everything is ahead, everything I gotta do, all this work, oh man, I'm so overwhelmed. Start thinking, what is one thing that I'm grateful for? Right? That's an easy way to get on the right track instead of letting your mind run wild and you're not asking for much, you're asking for one thing. What's one thing that I'm grateful for? What's one thing that I feel good about today? What's one thing that I'm excited about? And once you put your mind on that track, it rarely drifts off. And if it does, if your mind is so strongly conditioned to negative thinking patterns, then you need to keep forcing it. Keep forcing it one day at a time, right? It takes time, it takes effort, it takes energy. I'm not saying that your problems are gonna be solved like this. But what I am saying is that your problems will be solved if you apply this. In fact, if you use this, I will guarantee you that it'll work. My personal guarantee. You can come back on this video, you can tell me, you know what, man? Raphael, that was all BS, right? My belief system. I'm saying to you, it genuinely, really, really, really is one of the most powerful things I've ever seen. And I've seen it being applied with so many different people that I've worked with, and even just people around me. And it always has a powerful, significant impact, as long as you can shift, right? And if you're not comfortable with saying, I am this person, I am achieving this, then just start slowly. Just start one step at a time. Baby stepping your way to success is a lot better than trying to fly and spread your wings before you've even learned how to crawl. So if you're starting from the bottom, just take one step up. Go from I don't want this to wishing, I wish I could have this. It's better than saying I don't want that. So take your attention off what you don't want. Take it to wishing and hoping and praying for it, right? That's a lot better. Then take it up another step once you're ready. Once you're ready, assume that next level. Say, you know what? I'm becoming this. I'm achieving. I'm in the process. And once you're ready, take the final step and say, I am. And guess what happens after you take that I am step? Whatever it is that you believe, as long as you keep it in mind for longer period of time and you let it manifest and you genuinely put your energy behind it and you start backing it up with action, it becomes reality. That really is the secret. It becomes reality. If you can just keep your mind on that you're this person for long enough, you will become that person. You will have that experience of a shift, of a transformation, right? The reason somebody remains in bad shape is because they identify with it. Their thoughts are backing it. Everything in their life just reinforces it. What about being a smoker? It's the same thing. I'm a smoker. And you know, you go to an airport and you get put in this little thing. I mean, it's crazy, right? And it's like you're identifying with that personality. You might not be fully conscious or aware that you're doing it, but you're doing it. And society is pushing you into this box and giving you this narrative about who you are. And if you want to step out of it, now is the time to take your thoughts up a level at a time. And you have to change your identity. You have to change with the thoughts that you identify with. That's the most powerful thing. When you have a thought about, oh, I'm not good enough, and you really identify with that, like you really feel it in your heart and your soul and your body, and your whole mind becomes consumed, oh, what if I'm not good enough, right? Now you get so much pain being brought into your life. But the moment that you say, I am good enough, I'm capable, I have what it takes, I have it in me, I can do this, and you believe that, and you let that resonate through your body, wow. Those are two entirely different people. Those are two entirely different performances, and those are two entirely different worlds to live in.